Action 7 News continues to follow the Levi Chavez trial. Details about Tara Chavez's final weekend came from witnesses as the prosecution continues to build their murder case against Tara's then-husband, Levi Chavez. The former APD officer says his wife killed herself. Action 7 News reporter Ana Velasquez has the latest.
Thursday, October 18, 2007. Joseph Cordova saw his daughter Tara when he dropped her kids off. That was the last time he saw her alive.
She blew me a kiss and gave me the two thumbs up.
Cordova says Levi Chavez later told him that on that night, the couple got into a fight when Chavez returned home from work. Chavez left home and stayed with friends. The day before, Tara asked for a divorce.
She had said that she was done. She was done putting up with him and his cheating, and she was ready to move on with her life.
But that same weekend, her girlfriends say Tara expected Chavez back home.
She said they were going to talk about, I guess their living arrangements.
Instead, Chavez has said after his work shift ended Friday, October 19th, he immediately went to Deborah Romero's Albuquerque home, the woman he was dating.
I spent 6 years racking my brain over this as far as finding out what time it was. I don't know. I don't know, Mr. Cerna. What do you want me to tell you?
On Saturday, October 20th, Tara called in sick, but she texted her friends.
It was late at night, had to be between 10 and 11 o'clock at night. I was getting ready to get off work.
They say the nature of the messages were normal.
She just asked me what I was doing. I told her I was reading a book.
But the text message received by Levi Chavez Sunday, October 21st at 1:29 a.m. was different, and it was read by a Valencia County Sheriff's detective in a recording with Levi Chavez that night.
I'm afraid I'm going to hurt myself. So, and S-O-S-O-O-O. Upset, sad, and hurt, exclamation mark.
Chavez says Tara repeatedly threatened to hurt herself before, never did, and so he ignored that text. But when he returned to Los Lunas that night, he went to check on her after his mother told him she had a bad feeling. He called 911 after he says he found her dead, shot in the mouth. In Albuquerque, Ana Velasquez, KOAT, Action 7 News.
The trial resumes tomorrow, but the prosecution seemed to score a big win yesterday when key witness Deborah Romero took the stand and stood up to defense attorney David Cerna. We'll have more on that coming up later in this newscast. And remember, you can watch the trial live by going to KOAT.com. We are streaming all the action from the courtroom second by second every day. Reporter Ana Velasquez is also tweeting real-time updates, which you can find in the main media window.